लास्ट मंथ जिसको भी पूछो वो कश्मीर में थे. माय सिस्टर, माय फ्रेंड्स, माय रिलेटिव्स, माय नेबर्स एंड देयर रिलेटिव्स टू. एंड आई वाज लाइक, ओ माय गॉड, आई हैव नॉट बीन टू कश्मीर येट, आई नीड टू प्लान समथिंग. वेलकम टू द वर्ल्ड ऑफ फोमो. Hello everyone, welcome to She Knows on Wonder Woman Wednesday. I'm sure each one of you at some point or the other in their life have felt like you're missing out on something exciting, even though you're perfectly happy with what you're doing. That feeling is what we call FOMO, or the fear of missing out. In my younger days, we used to write diaries, and when people used to read it, we used to get so angry and so upset. Now we put out our blogs, vacay pictures, our moods, whatnot. And now we get angry if somebody doesn't read it or they don't like them. So with social media constantly showing us highlights of other people's lives, it's easy to feel like we are missing out something better. It's not that FOMO did not exist before, but it has become more prominent in this digital age. So let us understand, how does this FOMO get created and if there are ways to overcome it. So what really is FOMO? It's that anxiety we feel when we think that others might be having more fun, living better lives, or experiencing more than we are. And this feeling can make us feel dissatisfied with our own lives, though there's actually nothing wrong with it. So why do we feel FOMO? Here are a few reasons. First one, and the most important, is social media illusion. So social media platforms often show us a curated versions of people's lives. We see the highlights, but not the behind the scenes struggles. This creates an illusion that everyone else is living a perfect life. The recent movie Kho Gaye Hum Kahan talks a lot about this social media illusion. And there's a dialogue in that movie which goes like, social media makes you feel that you're more connected with people around, but in real, you have never been more lonely than this. The second reason we feel FOMO is because of the comparison trap. So we tend to compare our everyday moments with others' highlighted reels. And the comparison can make us feel inadequate and trigger FOMO. And the last one is obviously desire for social connection. Humans are social beings and we naturally want to be included and connected. So seeing others engage in activities can make us feel left out. Now that we have understood FOMO, let's talk about how to overcome it. And here are five practical tips. The first one is, of course, limit social media use. So set specific times for social media and stick to them. Keep app timers that will help you track when you exceed. This helps you control your exposure to the curated content and reduces the chances of feeling left out. Practice gratitude. Focus on what you have rather than what you lack. Create a gratitude journal and note down things that you're thankful for every day. Now, this can shift your perspective and can significantly reduce FOMO. Be present. In Ye Jawani Hai Diwani, Naina tells Bunny.
जितना भी ट्राई करो बनी, लाइफ में कुछ ना कुछ तो छूटेगा ही। तो जहाँ है, वहीं का मजा लेते हैं।
Basically, enjoy the moments wherever you are instead of running from one place to another. Practice mindfulness to fully engage with your current activities and appreciate the present. Set realistic expectations. Understand that no one can be everywhere or do everything. It's okay to miss out on some things. Prioritize what truly matters to you and let go of the rest. Last one is about building genuine connections. Focus on building deep, meaningful relationships rather than superficial ones. Spend quality time with your loved ones and engage in activities that truly bring you joy and fulfillment. Remember Akash, Sameer and Sid of Dil Chahta Hai? The three friends experience true joy, not through social media, but by spending quality time together. I know it's easier said than done. But when we start realizing, what do we want in life? FOMO or contentment? Being happy or feeling lonely? Frustrated seeing what others have or gratitude for what we have? Then we'll start making the right choice. So FOMO can lead to constant dissatisfaction and anxiety and prevent us from enjoying the present and appreciating what we already have. So these are just a few ways to overcome FOMO and lead a more fulfilling life. If you found these insights helpful, give us a thumbs up, share this video, and don't forget to subscribe for more such content. Now let us know, what is that one thing that you fear missing out from in your life? Share your thoughts in the comments below. Thank you for joining us today. Keep supporting, keep sharing, and keep shining. Until next time, take care and stay mindful.